There is an upsurge in banditry and kidnapping on the Abuja-Kaduna Highway is getting unbearable. The experience of travelers plying the routes can best be described as hellish. In a viral video, travelers were seen stranded for hours at the Regina axis of the highway while bandits operated unchecked. Let's share this video with you. Julie, last week I saw this video and I was like, this particular road, we've known that, look, this road is dangerous. And that is what has led to the, upsurge in the number of passengers that will go travel.
I think this is even a different video, because that video, you will see people narrating what they are going through and all that.
So people refer to the train from Abuja to Kaduna and Kaduna back. All the VIPs, they go through this train. They've abandoned this road. It's not as if this road is bad, but because of the security situation on this road, they've effectively abandoned the road. Do you know what is the big deal about this road? Why can't we police this road effectively?
The bandits who operate on that highway, they don't live in the area. They live far away. So even if you police the highway, you cannot police it for 24 hours. They will wait for some time when they can see that, okay, in this particular area, there is no presence of security agents. Then they will now suddenly come out and start robbing people. From my experience, there is between this Regina, that video that we saw, the one we were talking about, not the one that we just saw, that video was shot in Regina. So between Regina and Krumi Kare, there is a dense forest. That dense forest can take you all the way to Kachia, which is about 60 kilometers. And on both sides, once you get to that axis, that point that I'm talking about, there is thick forest on both sides. Bandits thrive on forest. Where your community is not heavily forested, you are not likely to be suffering from bandits. What they want is a situation in which they can find where to hide people. And that is what is happening. The people who use this road, they know that that whole area, right up to Sirikin Power, because of the forest, that's the most dangerous part of that highway. All that we need to do is activate our intelligence gathering capability. If security agents need to blend with residents of those communities, let's do it so that we can get more information about these guys before they operate. We stop them. We've seen people get on that road and they easily get kidnapped. That's why once people can't use the trains, it's a problem. Even security agents, police, generals, they prefer to enter the train. Their convoy will go and wait for them at the terminal. Because nobody wants to be kidnapped. That's what we are seeing. And for some time, it seems like those guys had left that place alone. But in the last 2 weeks, we've seen a return to the Abuja Highway. And it's very, very embarrassing that a place that is not far from the seat of power could be coming under unremitting attack by bandits.
There was a time I had to complain to the first PRO about the security presence between Lagos, Djibouti, or down to Asaba, down to the east. The number of checkpoints that we counted, it was going to like 400 from Lagos to Djibouti, from Djibouti to Ore. And then I complained bitterly to him that what's happening? I would tell that they've commercialized that particular route. So what is happening in the stretch of Abuja, Kaduna, that we can't have strong presence that will be there 24/7? Because these people, they have like...
even when you have strong presence, I think we discussed this the last time I came here also. That was on, I think, on Monday, that we discussed this issue of this one happened after the first one that happened. And the truth of the matter is, even if you put checkpoints everywhere, they will still look for a spot where there is no security presence. That's the truth of the matter. What I think we should do is to be more proactive. Let's check these things before they happen. And where we even have to, the police have to confront them. There is something we need to get. We need to strengthen the capacity of our police. The one that is happening in Niger State, the SSG said something. He said, these bandits will come in with maybe 200, like 200 motorcycles and all of that, and they have rounds of ammunition in their bags, while police have like 4 to 10 rounds of ammunition. See, they are even stronger than the police when it comes to what, when it comes to the weapons they have. So we have to increase the capacity of our law enforcement agencies and the capacity to gather intelligence. It's very, very important.
As usual, the president has read the riot acts again, that that place should be fortified and in a reactionary way. But I'm sure somebody died. I'm sure they would have
killed people. No, that video that you are seeing was when the governorship candidate from Zamfara was killed, because his even his truck, I mean his SUV, was identified inside the bush, and then some other people were also kidnapped. The other video happened even after that one. So you now wonder what is going on. If this happened and they took a life, they shot a prominent person, and they took away many people, and then they were back. So the people now refused to advance. Once they got information that they were operating in Regina, they just decided to stay where they are, and it caused a long hold up. And when they were asking, they said no, that they were asking them, is that about the security? They said that those guys, once they heard that these guys had come, that they left. Which brings me to the point that I made. If you do not have enough rounds of ammunition, you are looking at what you have. You are thinking that the enemy probably has more. And the weapon that you are carrying is probably the same as that of the enemy. It is the person who has more rounds that will most likely prevail. So there are times when our troops, our policemen simply retreat. They say who fights and runs away lives to fight another day. They simply will retreat, then wait for reinforcement. When reinforcement now comes, they overwhelm the enemy and reclaim their position. So this is a common military strategy to withdraw when you can see that the enemy appears to have superior firepower. So if those guys were coming to that scene, and you have maybe just three policemen, and they were coming with about 100, you know, it makes no sense to wait. You have to vote with your feet so that you can fight another day.
I'm moving on.